Alrighty guys, here's something interesting that I had no idea about. Hopefully this will be some useful information to help you guys out for a future problem. Working on the old Chevy Lumina in here, the pre-ran that we ran at Greenfield. If you remember, that car had a messed up alternator and the engine shoved backwards and also broke the bracket for the alternator. Well, I went to the junkyard and grabbed another alternator and a bracket off of another Chevy Lumina. And come to find out, there are actually two completely different alternators and brackets for the Chevy Lumina. So be very careful which ones you pull off. I'll show you the difference here. Here's the original one that I just pulled off. You can see it has three bolts there. One bolt up here for the alternator, and there's supposed to be a bracket right there, which would be your other side, just like that one, that holds your alternator in place. That bracket broke off during the Derby. Here it is, still attached to the alternator. You look right here, this alternator attaches by one bolt there and one bolt there, total of two bolts up on the corners, the ears of it. Now, this other style that I grabbed, when you look at it from under the hood, it looks about the same. It has a front ear with a bolt right there, which is your exact same hole right there. But it also has these two side spots where there's two bolts on the side that hold it down. So this alternator has a total of three bolts that hold it in place. This one has a total of two bolts that hold it in place. And here's the bracket off of the other style that I found when I pulled that off. You can see right there it has the same ear up top, just like the other one. But the back of it has these two bolts here to hold the alternator in place. And this one had that one ear up here. Now the good news is, if you do end up getting these, they are interchangeable to the engine itself. If you look, one, two, three, those three bolts, one, two, three, those three are the exact same. They line up on the engine block just fine. You'll also notice back here, this one has a bolt right there to hold it to the back of the engine. This one also has that same bolt hole right here to the back of the engine. So these will interchange, but you have to have the correct bracket for the correct alternator, and you have to keep them both together when transferring them from one engine to the other for the Chevy Lumina. Now, I don't remember the exact year of Chevy Lumina that I took this other style off of. Maybe it's the older, like a 95 and older style Lumina. I cannot remember. Or maybe there was just two different ones they used based on which factory this was under production. I'm not sure. So something to pay attention to, guys, if you do end up breaking a bracket or have to replace an alternator, you have to make sure you know which one it is to get the correct match for that pair. So, that has been removed, and here's the old one. If you didn't know how bad it was before, check out this. That is really hard to turn, by the way. It's about ready to lock up. It is just squealing. It is junk. You can see little bits of rubber dust right here from the belt burning up on it. So goodbye, alternator. You're junk. This one here is good. No noises, no squealing, no grinding. I'll put it on the car, and with the car running, I'm going to put my test meter on my battery, and we'll make sure the battery is getting a flow going into it for a charge. Because just because an alternator doesn't make any squealing noises doesn't mean it's good. You still could have an electrical problem internally and not charge. So it's a risk you take from getting one from a junkyard. We'll find out. But there you have it, guys. Those two are going together. This one's going to be set aside. I'm going to get them back up here. We're going to put it back on this car. Got my belt off right now. We're going to slap it all back together. Hopefully this thing will start up and run perfectly fine. You know, that was the only main issue with the engine, was that alternator. Stay tuned, we're going to start piecing more of this car back together and really assess what's left on it.